Okay, you may come across while in practice where you have to break news to the patient. It may be good news or bad news. In case of breaking the bad news, we need to follow certain protocol and we need to make sure that we do not drift away from that. So I'm going to tell you how to approach the breaking bad news situation wherever you come across such situations. We have a protocol which is a SPIKES. It is a S stands for setting up the conversation where we create all the atmosphere, and then the perceptions, then invitation from the patient and knowledge of the patient, emotion, sympathy, empathy, and S stands for strategy and the summary. So we will continue applying in the next scenarios. We are going to start practicing on them one by one. Let's talk about all those components of SPIKES protocol individually. The first thing among the SPIKES protocol is setting up the conversation, then perception, then invitation, then knowledge and emotions and strategy and summary. Setting up and starting the conversation, this is very important. We need to create the atmosphere which is noiseless, where there is no disturbance. We need to make sure that no one bothers when you start the conversation, no one calls you. So we need to keep our bleeps away, keep the phones away, and inform anyone who can come in the room that we are going to be busy. You need to notify on the door that room is busy, or knock the door if you want to come in, like those kind of things. Maintain the privacy, make sure that no one else who is not required is sitting in there. And then remove any distractor. If there's any phone, just make sure that you take the receiver off and do not get distracted by them. And then sit down with the patient or with the relatives and make good eye contact, introduce yourself, and check their identity, check their relation with the patient. This is all about setting up and starting the conversation. The first thing comes in SPIKES is setting up and starting the conversation. So again, in summary about the setting up, it should be noiseless, without any distraction, and we introduce each other and sit comfortably, make a good eye contact with each other. Then we move forward. Then assess the patient's own perception or the family's perception, whoever is there in that meeting. Identify by asking them what do they understand from this meeting, what do they expect from this meeting, determine what they have already informed about what we will be talking about in today's meeting. Say, for example, if you want to discuss about the end of life of a patient, and you are arranging a meeting with the patient's family, so find out whether or not they know or they have the understanding that this meeting is actually about their relatives or about the patient's end of life care. So that's very important. And listen to them very carefully. And wherever you find the information is right, acknowledge that, okay? Then the next thing that comes is an invitation. After you have set up, after you have confirmed the perception, then wait for the family, okay, doctor, or the patient to invite you, okay? So the invitation is not from your side, it is mainly from the patient. Whenever you're going to break any bad news, say for example, if you want to break the bad news of a cancer to a patient, you after receiving the confirmation of the perception, wait for the patient to say, "Okay, doctor, now go on, please tell me what you want to say. So that's the invitation from the patient. Okay. Ask them, if the patient does not tell you, give a brief gap and ask them, do you want me to carry on further or you want me to wait? And then you move to the next step. Knowledge and information, we need to, as I mentioned, we need to acknowledge that, warn the patient about the bad news. Today we are going to discuss about the malignancy or about the results. Unfortunately, I do not have any good news. So then give a brief period of break and sit quiet, wait for the patient to absorb that information and be ready for the next part of the information. Okay, that is called the warning shot. So we need to give them the warning shot. Start the patient's level of comprehension and vocabulary. Do not use a medical terms. Use a layman language that is easy for the patient to understand. And do not be so blunt with the patient. We need to show sympathy, empathy, everything, and show that by your attitude. Do not be rude to the patient. And we need to give them the information in small pieces so that they can absorb it easily. Without giving a lot of information that they cannot really understand. We need to make sure that whatever information, the piece of information you have already given, the patient has understood and absorbed. Now the patient is ready to take more information. So this is how we provide them information in small pieces. And anything that you can cause distress to the patient should be avoided, like using, God forbid, and you don't know about the patient's religion, if they have any belief in the God, and we cannot do anything, there is nothing more that we can do. Then all those sentences can cause a distress to the patient. So we need to show the sympathy and empathy to the family, to the patient, and we need just focus on our obligations as a clinician, where we know that we are talking about the patient's quality of life, how we can improve. If we cannot improve, what will be the outcome of the patient, if the patient gets a treatment or if the patient does not get the treatment, or if we see that being non-maleficent, being beneficent, and completely justifying the treatment, doing everything, will not help the patient, and there is nothing much to do, then we are considering the patient's own comfort. So we need to compile all the information and deliver to the patient and mention that we are talking now about how we can proceed, how we can decrease the pain or the distress that you may have if you are not going to survive in that situation. So that's very important. Then we need to be sympathetic throughout. We need to consider empathy as well throughout this process of conversation. Observe for any emotions. If the patient starts crying, then stop. Do not continue just giving and delivering the information, delivering and delivering and talking and talking. If the patient is crying, offer them the tissue. But otherwise, if you don't think that the patient, if you see that the patient is not crying, then no need to offer them the tissues or anything. You can offer them water whenever you go in your clinical exam. There may be a jug of water with a glass. So if you see that the patient is distressed, you can offer them water. Ask them, do you want me to give you some water? If the patient is crying, there may be a box of tissue. So you should get the tissue box and give it to the patient. So we should never lose sympathy and empathy. And at the end of the conversation, we always need to summarize about whatever we have gone through, starting from setting and then checking the perception and everything, we need to summarize whatever we have discussed so far in summary at the end, and then make the final plan. Say, for example, if we were talking about a patient who is terminally ill and is diagnosed with the metastatic lung cancer, which has now spread everywhere, and you don't think that providing any sort of management will benefit the patient. So we need to go through everything, and at the end, we can discuss, and we should discuss now. Shall we make the final plan? Let's see what we can do for you to stay comfortable till your last breath. Okay, so this is how we summarize, and at the end we create a plan and for the strategy for the patient. And at the end, again, ask if you have any question and offer them for the help. If they have any question in future, offer them how they can access you. If they get any more question, how they can reach you. Is there any possibility that we can arrange another meeting? So you invite them, offer them the help and the support, that if you need any more information, let the nurses know. I will be happy to come whenever possible, and we can arrange a meeting. We can decide about meeting time, and I will try to answer your questions again whenever you have. And also ask them if you get any question that you have forgotten now, or you do not have any question now in your mind. But if any question comes in your mind later on, you can always create a list of them, and you can ask the nurse to get the answers ready for those questions if you want, or you can keep with you and arrange a meeting and bring the questions in front of us so that we can answer.